We're live.
That's why I haven't done it, because every time I go to do it, it reminds me too much of her.
Make joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know
bless his name, for the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. We're going to come into his courts singing with praise and with thankfulness tonight, and I'm super glad you guys are here.
Thank you.
into that place. So that's what we want to invite you to tonight as we continue. And however you want to express that, you're free.
Thank you.
a messed up Achilles for like 4.5 years now, which doesn't feel like a good thing, but so many good things have come out of it. It's so many good things. Relationships that I wouldn't have had, and opportunities that I wouldn't have had. So he's still faithful in that. So we're just going to play through this a couple times, the chorus, and I just want to encourage you to think about those things that he's done for you that are good, and to thank him for it, just to remember. And then we'll sing it again a little bit.
Thank you. Anybody want water?
Yeah, water's right in front of them.
There's water everywhere.
Now that it's finally warm enough.
Okay, I gotta tell you one more thing about me. I didn't mean to, but, you know, it's all happening. Well, some of you know this already, but some of you don't really know, so I just wanted to share with you. But so I met Jesus when I was 15, 14, I don't know, 14 or 15. Like, I grew up in church, but I didn't really know Jesus yet. And I met him during worship, which is why I love worship so much. And I have, like, a lot of things going on. Like, I don't have, like, a terrible life or anything, but I have some significant challenges in my childhood. And that just left me basically feeling like I had to do everything. Like, I had to take care of myself, and I couldn't trust anyone else, including God. And as you can imagine, that didn't work out really well for me. It mostly just made me mean, which I didn't really love. So I was at this youth conference, and my mom made me go to, and I was kind of bitter that she made me go to it, but I went. There were like over 1,000 teenagers there, and I didn't have any friends. But I was like sitting on the floor of this arena, and I don't remember what anyone talked about, but I do remember that they kept talking about Jesus loving us. And that was kind of the only thing that I heard, because I was like, what are you talking about? And they were talking about how, like, that relationship with him, he was like a friend. And I was like, no, I don't think so. I know me. But I basically got to a point during worship one night with, like, no one talking to me, where I was like, man, like, what I'm doing isn't working. And so, can't hurt to ask. And so, like, I didn't, like, super know how to pray or anything, but I was just like, in my mind, I was like, so God, this is what people are saying about you, and if it's true, will you show me? And I know it sounds weird, but I've said this a million times, but the best description I can give is I felt like someone was giving me a giant hug, and I'm a big hugger, so that was awesome. And I felt love for the first time in my whole life, and I like burst into tears, which I am not a crier. But it was like tears of joy, because I felt loved, and I knew like who he was, and that it was true, and I didn't need any other proof. And it was a drastic enough change in my life that when my mother picked me up that night, she looked at me and said, what happened to you tonight? Put it in a good way. And I just looked different. She said I looked light. That was because I was. And it changed my whole life, and now I love people because I love Jesus. Because he loves me. So, I just wanted to tell you that because I want to encourage you to have those conversations with him too. If there's something you're questioning or something you don't know, or if like you hear people talking about having relationships with him and you don't know what that is yet, like even if you believe in him but you don't really know what that means, like I want to encourage you to ask him and to take that time and have that space, because he will answer you. It's pretty awesome when he does.
Come to me.
party.
Thank you.
words we're going to sing, okay? And you just think in your mind and in your heart if they are applicable right now. Alright? So the chorus says, build your kingdom here. Let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand. Heal our streets and land. Set your church on fire. Win this nation back. Change the atmosphere. Build your kingdom here. Right?
Amen.
Alright. So you gotta like sing with us and dance with us and you know like we're gonna have a good time. Alright? This is our last song, so you gotta go all out.
Oh, Yeah.